the freestyle by Corey Holcomb and this bitch. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. I don't like your daughter, bitch. Ever since I saw the little hoe, niggas knocking on my motherfucking door.
Is Trina there? Is she coming out?
I say, hey, put that thing in that bitch mouth. Cause I don't like your daughter, bitch. Going in my refrigerator. Every nigga that nut in her, somehow they hate her.
Oh.
Her two kids that she kept cause she thought them dudes was gonna give her fuck. But then they ducked out on her ass. Fuck that silly slut. Even though that bitch do got a big ass butt. But I won't fuck her though. Cause it's your daughter. But get the daughter out my face before the slaughter. I don't like your daughter, bitch.
Oh, I told you he answered shit.
That's the big homie right
there. Pass me that shit.
Get this shit.
Don't open it yet. Just get it to me like that.
Get this shit started, nigga.
Nigga shit.
Brown plastic. Yeah. You understand?
That's what's up. We on?
Oh.
What up, nigga? 5150. Made it another week. I don't take these weeks for granted.
I know these not at all.
Precious times where you can get on the mic, because I heard a lot of my fans in Europe couldn't see the show.
Yeah, you in Europe? Yeah, last show.
All over the place. This is the internet.
Man, this is the internet.
Okay, shout out to across the pond.
Oh, wait a second. Now let's introduce before we can.
All my people, they know Maranzio.
They know.
Just in case we have some new.
They gonna start talking shit to me in a second.
New motherfuckers is Maranzio. He looked like the Mad Magazine, a ghetto Mad Magazine face, nigga.
I look like a healthy Tommy Davidson.
Oh my Lord Jesus,
nigga, that's fucked up.
I want to say,
are you saying Tommy Davidson
looks pretty sick?
I like your hat.
Hey, Tommy, you know motherfucker go in on this show. Don't get sensitive. Tommy Davis is signify too.
Oh, yeah.
He'll go. No.
Tommy Davis is a...
He'll go.
He can go. So
he owe you one.
He can try. No,
let me tell you something. One day, I was getting on the plane in Burbank. Burbank to Vegas flight. You know, you running to everybody on them flights.
That's a quick flight. You running to everybody.
Yeah.
Me and Tommy Davis sitting down on the plane.
Oh, God.
Wayne Brady walked past.
Oh, my God.
Tommy Davis was like, hey, what's up, man? Yeah, you know. I was like, what's up, too? Because I know Tom Brady like, I mean.
Wayne Brady.
Wayne Brady. It passed it like that. He's a cool nigga.
Yeah.
That nigga, Tommy, was like, bust your ass.
You just called out Tommy Davis.
Oh, I ain't really called out. Hey, Tommy, what, 50 years old?
That don't mean 50. He's
50.
You think you can take him?
What, is signifying?
Yeah.
No. Well, it depends. Let me tell you something. Tommy Davidson, let me tell you something. Fuck that shit. I'm so
confident in a motherfucker.
First of all, I got respect for Tommy Davidson. Can I say that?
I got mad respect for Tommy.
Tommy Davis and them was doing this shit when they weren't even letting niggas do this shit.
Nigga, that nigga had a dope ass hour special for Showtime back in the day.
Yeah.
Dope one.
And was he called with Philly, Wildcat, impersonations and shit.
Yeah.
This ain't no shit with niggas.
Bang, bang, bang.
Right. Niggas ain't dissing my nigga.
Ain't nobody dissing. I'm just a youthful version of him.
Tommy Davidson, when he ain't high.
When he ain't high.
He
good.
Y'all will go at it.
But
if he high,
I'm going to fuck him up.
If he high, he'll start crying.
He'll start.
You talking about me?
Car broke down. He'll
be like, what the fuck? Is this Tommy?
Niggas had that nigga with intervention face. The LeBron James face now. When he won the title.
Oh, when LeBron face, when he cried, that nigga face
you.
Was like.
But you didn't hear it. Can you imagine being hurt? Have you heard that?
LeBron, please don't ever cry again. Your face turned into something. That lining, your lining ain't right.
But
to cry
faces for that everybody.
Ain't,
just...
ain't no lining.
That's as ugly as a person get when they cry.
No, a real when, cry? No. When you're trying to hold in a cry. No. When you're fighting back a cry.
It don't matter.
I don't
crying
think so.
Crying makes you look ugly than a motherfucker.
Ooh, that, no. Come on now. That's like a spank cry. That's like a
cry. Yeah.
I cry all the time.
Why?
When I laugh, I can't help it.
You cry when you laugh. That's
oh,
not
my
the same,
God.
That's not the same type of cry, though.
No, but
where your cry face at?
No, but when I do cry, it what's just your, comes out. I don't do all that it? All.
She be trying to hold it in. Some girls
no,
be like,
I don't.
I want to see
trying
this.
To look cute
no.
and shit.
Funeral cry face.
No, I don't care. I'll cry at the drop of a dime. I can't help it.
Why?
Like if Mimi wore your shoes and you ain't know it and you put them on.
Oh, very funny. No. Stop it. No, really. I have a real sensitive trigger.
If you woke up and Bobby had you tied down in a bed and he was touching you,
no, I would
licking
just,
his.
Oh, I, no, I would die. I would not cry. I would just go into a coma and die. I would just.
Come on, Bobby got that motherfucking tobacco Kagan breath.
Let me taste your nipples.
Oh, go! Yeah. I'm about to die now.
They look
for
like
real.
They taste
I'm
like something. Let me look on.
Why? What's happening?
That's Bobby.
That's oh. No.
You know, Bobby take pride in being a sex machine. What? He say he got stamina. You know, Bobby, well, I put this Murfreesboro on that bitch.
Murfreesboro?
Put my foot on a rock.
Let me put that Murfreesboro on.
Yeah, but maybe
I ain't had to pay rent in a year.
Nigga, an I ain't trusting no nigga that use Tussie as deodorant.
And I'm not on medication.
Oh. Right. I ain't on no medication.
You know how old Tussie is.
Mm. Tussie.
Tussie that shit to wipe out the...
Yeah.
Man,
yeah.
Nigga, I'm old. I know what Tussie deodorant is, nigga. That's some good-ass deodorant. You don't be funky with that shit.
Nah, that shit will last you about 3 days.
Don't find. Do you ever seen the Tussie roll-on?
Nah.
It's going to fuck your shirt up, but you're not going to be funky. You might well throw that shirt away under there.
Under there, that shirt
going to be like cardboard.
But you be well protected.
Oh, that motherfucker.
Nigga, shirt ain't shit, but he fresh.
Only thing you can get it off your shirt is Kagan water.
Oh. Kagan water?
Kagan water, good for everything.
Kagan water, that's what Bobby sell.
Good for everything, you understand?
Bobby good with that Kagan water. He got me to buy one of them little pussy-ass fountains.
What the fuck Bobby at right now?
Huh?
Hey, that
what Bobby at now?
What time is it? 8:36. Bobby almost sleep. He Bobby go to bed early and get up with the chicken.
That's a shit.
Stop.
Bobby wake I'm up early. Only time wrong. Bobby out late at night is when he having a drinking spell.
That nigga That nigga wake up when the Lord get up. My grandma said, "I'm gonna get up when the Lord get up."
I'm mad at Bobby. I just gotta keep my distance so I can stay loving my nigga. If I see him every day, I'm gonna jump down his ass.
No, I'm not. Stop.
Rooster nigga. Wash his clothes with Kagan water.
We love Bobby. Ain't nothing. Don't take it personal.
Tussie water.
Look at Joe putting in the little shit. Bobby know you his friend, motherfucker.
They get back to Bobby. Bobby come. Y'all said something about me. This.
And old girl know you her friend. The thief.
What?
This Frankenberry looking bitch.
Oh my God.
This bitch look just like Frankenberry. Now tell me this bitch don't look like Frankenberry.
I need a picture of Frankenberry.
Put a picture of Frankenberry and the POTUS together.
Oh my God. I was
POTUS?
POTUS.
Because there's nothing wrong.
POTUS, he used to work at
Yeah.
Who's Frankie?
Oh.
Tell me she don't look like Frankenberry from the series. Frankenberry.
I don't want to say her name.
Why you don't want to say her name?
Come on.
POTUS.
POTUS look like Frankenberry?
Yeah.
I thought you were talking about the girl she be hanging out with.
Uh-oh.
Who?
Dang, it's a...
Yeah.
Nikki.
Yeah.
Nikki got weight on her. If Nikki lost a lot of weight...
She would look like...
What if she lost a lot of weight? People don't know Nikki, though. Some people know Nikki, but I'm just saying, if she lost weight, would she be bad?
No.
I ain't think so.
Like, ain't nothing you can do about that. It's over.
Oh, my
she ain't
God.
No ugly bitch now.
Like, you came to her rescue like, hey, now... I fuck on a slow night.
Wait a minute, let me think how she really look.
Oh,
would you fuck? Look,
the reason you think that because she be with old girl or used to be with old girl.
I seen her by herself and I still think that.
No, fuck that. When you see a bitch with a bad bitch and the bitch ain't even ugly, you tell me that don't look like Porter.
Oh my God,
that's a made up picture of Porter.
Come on,
that's a made up picture of Porter.
Is beautiful.
Y'all got to get a real picture of Porter. It's not without the makeup on.
Y'all ain't shit for that right there.
That's y'all.
You play a part in this goddamn
said
shit.
Portis was beautiful.
Hey, man, please find a picture of Portis when she's smiling or crying.
Stop.
Look at Frankenberry.
How are we going to find them pictures?
I know. Because
she don't cry.
Anyway.
She don't give a
fuck. Okay, here's a system, right? This is how I look at women. You depend on how attractive a woman
take
is.
Take them pictures down, Chris.
Say you own a restaurant, right? Mm. And the chick walk in. Depending on how fine she is, it determines if you'll turn the grill back on. Because once you turn the grill off, you're not turning the grill back on. That's it for the day. If a bitch walk in, be like, I'll turn the grill back on for that bitch.
Would you
cut the grill back on for Nikki? Or would she have to eat whatever's left over?
This nigga said, I don't. You know, I can't really picture Nikki's face for real because I'm just I don't remember her being no ugly bitch. See, when I see a bitch that's ugly, I'll be like, oh, that bitch ugly.
Imagine a bitch double dutching in Detroit, Michigan right now.
This is how you can tell.
Acid rain coming
this is how you can tell how a bitch
What's
really
wrong
look.
With you?
What is wrong with both wrong y'all? With oh my God, what is wrong with both of you?
Acid rain coming down. What is wrong?
Double dutching, barefoot, nigga.
Acid rain.
With a rain pop in the hand.
What is
and pop rocks in the back pocket.
You got to handle that. You want me to go right into it? Then just introduce me, Zoe. Let's go.
Listen.
Uh-oh. He said, hold on.
You want me bad?
Okay, so look. I want to say this about a bitch.
Oh, God.
She's a turn off the grill type bitch.
When a bitch, you got to wake up in the morning with a bitch and see her talk just waking up. That's when you really know how a bitch look.
Right.
This shit. You know what I'm saying? That's the truth right there. Right. How that bitch look when she say her first words in the morning, when she wake up. You ever, sometimes I wake bitches up on purpose. I'll be like, hey, what's wrong with you? Like, that's how I you really, really look, bitch. You what's wrong with me? Your looks, bitch.
Like you fucking with bitches that been stolen.
Right, bitch.
But look, once again, we have your personal preferences, okay? Right. So let's just get that straight, that's Corey's take on...
I look like this when I wake up.
Oh, my God.
You think he cute?
I am, actually.
Oh, good Jesus.
Very handsome, debonair guy.
Ahead,
oh, my Lord.
I'm not about to go down that road.
You are begging to me.
Uh-oh, he wake up.
It's my Orange Juice Jones.
Oh, Lord.
To give our love another try. Bitches like me when I have my hair combed and shit.
So what
at the club. That's her right there with Cedric.
Oh, damn. That's Nikki? God damn. Oh,
that's recent. That was just taken. Yeah. You cutting the grill back on for that?
I forgot that bitch looked like that.
Shit.
Damn. On the Sean Kemp side of the game.
Bitch got on them Reebok Rain Man.
Are you egging him on?
No.
What?
You're egging him on.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, I didn't know she looked like that. She got on makeup and shit. She ain't. Well, shit.
She like before and after.
As soon as you argue with her, you go, bitch, I know your ugly ass ain't talking to me.
Why?
Oh, my
That's
God.
Fucked up. She that ain't is. Ugly, though. You crazy.
That bitch look.
Who look better, her or Portis?
Portis.
I knew you were going to say that because she light skinned. You fucking haters.
No, nigga. I just don't leave no bitch look like Evander Holyfield.
That is a Holyfield face right there.
She like she could take a punch and be like, and what else you got?
You bit my ear off, nigga.
I don't know how we got on all this.
Uh-huh. That bitch got the Holyfield face. You hit it for real right there. Nikki, I hope y'all see this and get mad at me, but that is the Holyfield face right
that
there.
That is a tranny face if I've ever seen one.
Right, okay, fuck it. I forgot how she really looked. I thought it was just the Claudia effect.
Because
Claudia cute and shit. I'm just saying, is Claudia cute? You can't take shit away from her.
I mean, if you scan all the way down to stop at her ankles.
I saw them feet, though.
Nigga.
I saw them
stop.
Feet.
Oh, stop. You could ignore them. And then,
cute,
yeah.
Y'all can't say Claudia cute.
I didn't say
ain't
she
nobody
wasn't cute.
Nobody say she wasn't cute. We just said from the ankles down.
Bam, bam, on Flintstone feet, dog.
Oh, God.
Bam.
She put out fires in Santa Ana with her feet.
A ninja will be like, she'll be like, cow.
Up, I can't.
Her feet are a fatality on Mortal Kombat. Finish her.
I didn't even believe that was that her bad. Feet when they showed me them feet.
Somebody showed the feet. The feet ain't.
No, she got them fixed.
What?
I don't remember the feet.
You can't fix feet.
Yes, you can.
No, you can't.
How yes, you can. Feet?
Your life as a track star.
I've seen
they don't make toe braces.
Oh, yes, I've
when
seen
them. When your feet
them.
Go on, Ike.
No, I've seen.
If you got the bunion, they got surgery where they take
they
that
can take the bunion off.
They can take that knuckle off.
When you got a fat big toe, that's it.
I know a girl, and she is a dime, except her toe, that big toe.
Look like Dante Culpepper.
That big toe look like a titty.
Wait, what?
I said, this bitch got a titty toe.
A titty toe.
Titty toe, nigga.
Oh. Nigga.
Milk look like it come out that toe.
Leche,
and the
nigga,
rest of her feet regular. It's just that one toe.
Leche.
I was like, bitch, you need to get your toe line.
Oh, my God.
See? This bitch need a toe liner.
I can't stop. Listen, my eyes are watering.
Bolo.
Can't stop trying. It's just too damn.
Serious though.
You got the Danny Glover queued up?
All she got to do is keep on some motherfucking
You fuck that bitch in Missionary, and she try to put them foot by your face,
you
gonna
be like,
hey.
I I don't think you're going to mind at that moment.
I'm not going to mind.
Fuck him out of here.
D, you are wrong. Because let me tell you something.
If that, that shit scraped my ear, it's over. I got to get a tetanus shot.
In that moment, he is a moment.
Toleche.
Hey, let me tell you something, Pete. I mean, D.
And you're going to really be thinking about that.
Yeah, that bitch feeling like Wolverine.
One day this bitch burped while we was in bed. And that smell made me stop fucking with her. And she was naked and everything. But I was like, damn, you, that was in your soul?
Hold on, you was in the middle of fucking in this bitch burp?
It was that Hennessy McDonald's mix burp.
Oh.
But what? How she got time to burp?
So that bitch didn't burp.
This bitch drunk a lot of Hennessy. That wasn't loud. It snuck out. It was one of these.
But here's the problem.
And it came through that hand, and that motherfucker came toward me. It was like,
look, the problem. You fucked up. You fucked up because you fucked a missionary. You was looking at the bitch.
God damn it, you goddamn right.
She should be facing the wall.
Look, if you fuck every bitch doggy style, you gonna miss out on how much that bitch don't like fucking you. You better learn how much that bitch don't like fucking you.
Sometimes you gotta look at him.
Doggy style, you don't know. That bitch like this. Like,
I can't wait to this.
I got the same exact face. Like, I know I can do better.
Missionary, when they fake it, you can see. They be like, bitch, you don't like this. Let me hurry up.
Oh, my God.
Bolo.
Oh, when it's a good nut, I sound like that. That shit, he just that queued up.
Mariah Carey.
Nigga, you sound like this when you nut?
Hey, dog. There's some bitches out here with pussy flaming, boy. That pussy is magic. You be like, bitch, I'm about to fuck up.
Stop.
Stupid.
We done got Chris carried away with these sounds.
I love that shit. Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's the worst thing.
I hate to put you on the spot, Maranzio, but I don't think we asked you this on the show. We know Zoe does it. You ever ate a bitch ass? You hesitated, dawg. Don't you know I fucking
nigga
read
shaking
shit?
His head like
he did like this. He said,
I just like a 6-year-old. No, I've never done that.
I was drunk.
I just ain't got to that point yet.
You done did it. You hesitated. Let me tell you something about lying. The first thing you do is look down. What a motherfucker
do
this?
No, you look to the left. They say you look to the left.
You look to the left.
You look to the left when you just flat out lying. When you shame to yourself, you look down. Like,
wasn't no slave like, yeah, he caught me.
You ain't booty like groceries.
No, you know nigga, first of all,
was she a bad bitch?
Booty is groceries.
What do you think booty is? It is groceries. It's the shit that
you
ate.
Never went to Ralph's and like, yo, can I get a 6-pack of booty?
It's the groceries when you done with it.
You got some fresh ass over there.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to produce and get a fresh ass. You gotta squeeze it to make sure it's fresh.
You're right.
Maybe a little.
That one got a pimple on it. I'm gonna sit
play it
back.
Off if you want to.
That one got a pimple.
Booty is the groceries when you done with it, fool.
Darling, is eating ass a thing for you?
Is it a thing for
like,
me?
Like, do you like it? Do you enjoy it? Is that something that
she gonna get mad? She don't like
to
talk about.
Yeah,
her
I don't really
life.
Like to talk about that. I don't. Yeah,
she gonna get mad.
You gotta ask the
nigga.
No, I
don't get mad. I don't know why they say this, but I don't get mad. I just don't talk about it.
That's the same thing as getting mad because you like you put up a wall now. You defensive about it.
No, I'm not defensive.
No.
Mm-mm.
You just don't want to talk about
it. I just don't like
she don't like
about
talking
it.
About her personal life. You has that, we,
no, that's not true. That is not true. It's just certain things because I have a son. If I were to never have a son, then I would probably would have.
Do you think Ice-T would come on our show? Would he be like, nah, fuck that shit?
No, yeah, he wouldn't.
He wouldn't come on?
No.
Niggas like that.
I'm going to get Ice-T to come on this show.
With her on
as
the
much
show?
Crap as you talk.
Yeah. I don't talk shit about Ice-T.
We love the legend.
Wait, didn't he?
I talk about Ponytail.
Yeah, but that's who didn't he just go there and say something
Ice-T
about a fight?
Hip-hop
and
legend.
We said we would like to see that.
What fight?
You said something about a fight that you'd beat him up or you guys would fight.
If me and Ice-T got in a fight, I would be laughing too hard. I think I know you're
Ice-T gonna fight. Tell you all hustling. New Jack, but dick is hard.
Right.
But no, anyway, Maranzio, I don't get mad. They just know. I just don't want to talk about it.
But it's kind of pointless. Like, not pointless, but you bring a certain element being on the show.
Yeah.
So if you don't answer these questions, they go unanswered for the female.
Motherfucker, we've been doing this
show
so long.
It's too late. That's what I'm saying.
It's too late,
you
have to
add,
last week, if you would have been here, our homegirl Mimi is more
Exactly.
She asks the questions like that.
Okay.
And you can. I even told him a long time ago, you can get somebody else if you'd like, because I'm never going to do that. I've had a son. I'm never going to talk details about that ever.
See, she's starting to get hurt already.
No, I'm not. I'm just never going to do that. I have a son.
I get it.
And I would never disclose.
I respect.
I think
even, now don't ask her no more shit,
wait, though, and it doesn't matter
you
how
got
old.
Her off her fucking square
no,
now.
But I'm just saying, it doesn't matter how old I am or he gets. It just, I just think it'd be gross to ever know or hear your mother say something like that. I couldn't do it. No.
How old is he?
Be 25. But it doesn't matter. I could be 70. We really going to say, okay, well, now I'm going to start talking
be
about
quiet
my
before
pussy.
I show your son your book cover. Now, shut the fuck up.
He knows all of that. He sees all of that. What are you thinking?
Shut the fuck up.
What are you talking about?
You starting to sound like Michael Jordan now.
I've never had my shit exposed, though, Corey. I could have a bathing suit on, so what? But I've never showed my...
I'm fucking with you, D. Oh, you ain't never showed the monkey, right?
No, never. I would never do that. Never, ever, ever. Be broke as hell and never...
Never showed the monkey?
Nope. And I could have the last 2 years because it's been rough, but I would never do it.
Playboy, huh?
The monkey been rough or life been rough?
Life.
Oh.
I had a rough monkey.
I had to get clarity.
Stop. I'm going to need you to stop.
It's a rough monkey right there.
Hey, D. I mean, Maranzio.
Yeah.
Zo, you ever seen a dick pic?
Me?
Yeah.
Wait, sent one?
Oh, that's you answered it. You said, me?
One
time. Motherfucker, do you know who I am? One
time? Yeah.
Who was this special bitch?
She's special.
Wait.
So special you sent her a dick pic, huh?
Does she have your face in it?
No.
No.
That's what I was going to say, because I was going to talk about that a little later on.
I sent
about
the
it.
Whole shit.
I sent
one to get an Xbox 360. She told me, if you send me one, I'll buy you an Xbox 360. I want it.
No, this bitch
and
worked
you
at
sent
the airport,
one with
dog.
Your face in
hell no.
Okay, that's what
I did.
No.
That last minute ticket to Detroit was $900. This bitch worked for motherfucking Spirit. That bitch gonna see the whole thing.
Who
I needed that
would
flight.
Pay to see? Oh my
nigga,
god, that is
Spirit.
That's the craziest thing I've ever heard.
Nigga, that ticket last minute was higher than the motherfucker.
Is that another one question?
Have
that you
I ever
can't
sent
ask?
One? No, it's not a question.
I
have, but oh, I just don't put my face in it. Yeah.
Okay.
Of course. I just don't talk gross details, Maranzio. But
you
I
didn't
talk
answer
about
the question, Maranzio.
I said I did. I said I got a 360 out of it. Xbox 360.
That's right.
That's true.
I did.
Motherfucker did say that.
Niggas be scared to sit in their dick. Yeah, that shit gonna come back on you.
But the thing
day.
Is, you guys sent it without your face, so how do they
know? Anybody did.
But that's what I'm saying. How do they know it's yours? Because Corey has said he's pulled up fake penises before and sent
I didn't add dicks to my body.
Oh my god,
I'm impressive.
This nigga photoshopped the dick,
right?
I can't.
Them broke hoes don't know.
Oh god.
Oh, he killing them.
Jericho in the
this
house?
Nigga done put a prosthetic dick on.
I can't.
And
he
I
gonna
can't.
He gonna lay it down.
A light.
He walk in there with a hard ass Tic Tac.
He ain't got no gray hair on his dick. Oh,
like he say he does, because you always say you do.
Darling,
God,
what
damn.
Are you
I'm not mixing anything.
What are you?
Mexican.
Straight Mexican?
Uh-huh. Five generations here. Uh-huh.
Seriously?
Yep.
Stupid, nigga.
Mm-hmm. Straight well, Mexican. If you count great-great-great-grandma, she was 18 days old when they came across. There was no border, so we just say across.
Maranzio got some wacky
the border wasn't even built. Oh, stop.
I'm just trying to get Maranzio.
That was a good question,
this
Maranzio.
Shit like a Don Lemon interview and shit.
Oh,
nigga, because my ass ain't open. I'm straight.
You better not be.
Boom.
If I ever find out you fuck with boys, Maranzio, I ain't never fuck with you again. I told you to give me a heads up. All my friends who fuck with niggas, let me know so I can defend you when I have to.
Right, but you still stay friends with them, right? You're not. You're
if
not
you don't tell me,
guy.
I'm just letting you know. I got to go. I got to talk shit about you because you ain't tell me in the beginning. If God. I know in the beginning, I won't talk shit. But if you act like you a regular nigga and I find out you fucking with niggas, I'm going to go in. That's all I'm saying.
So how many people have we discussed on the show that are that way? Because you know they're out there.
There's a lot of motherfuckers who are out there.
He assumes, but he don't know for real.
I know a
but
gay
wait a minute.
Man
Corey
when I
has
see one.
Corey has followed niggas before.
That's right. I got free time.
This nigga's a private eye.
Well,
I'm talking about some major stars who nobody would think. They be on their late night creep. They go in them houses. All of a sudden, there'd be a nigga on the porch with him after an hour. They'd be hugging goodbye and shit. Love you, love you.
They got tongue rings?
I don't know. I
won't even talk to you if you got a tongue ring.
I know we've talked about this before. Who was it that said
it? Love you too, Nick.
Has a tongue ring?
Who?
Tim Duncan had the tongue. He had the tongue ball at the All-Star game.
But that's what it is. It's a. It goes in and it's a ring, but it's a
niggas be on a step ladder fucking the shit out of Tim Duncan.
Stop. Oh, my God.
Bring that ass down here. Tim Duncan got to lay with his legs all the way open to get fucked from the back.
Oh, my God.
That foot be high as hell. He be like, are you done? My career's done. I'm just fucking with you. Timmer! You know I'm fucking with you, my nigga.
What is going on?
God. I saw Tim Duncan at the airport. Damn. He did not want me to say nothing to him. And I wasn't. It's just he saw another black dude. He thought I was going to be like, Tim Duncan! I just was walking. I wanted to be like, faggot ass,
whatever,
Nick.
Dick
in the booty ass, Nick. I bet he'd have wanted to talk to me after that. No, that ain't true. My wife was just mad at me. Get your pussy ass out of here. That little motherfucking bitch say that shit unless she done came home to pulsating ass from recovery. Ass when it recovers still do this.
What's wrong with him, man?
What?
Maron's here. What is going on?
I know I done took some. Man, let me tell you
this
something.
This nigga just took a 20-year NBA veteran and put this nigga over a couch getting banged out by random niggas.
On a step ladder. What is going on?
It's this club.
A Hall of Famer.
Called Zany's in Nashville.
In Tennessee.
If you eat these wings at Zany's, your ass going to get blew out. These are the hottest wings in the history of hot wings.
How do we get on hot wings from Tim Duncan's ass?
Because it happened to me.
Oh. What you mean? Boy, wait.
Them wings came out my ass.
Oh, yeah.
They came out my ass with knives on the side.
Exactly.
One more time. That's how I was when I was sitting. Them knives had sticker bug outfits on. I mean, them wings was.
You know the look.
Them wings had sticker bugs on them when they slid out my ass. When I went to sleep, I felt my ass like remember that Huey Lewis song?
Oh, my God.
They say
God.
The heart of rock and roll.
Are you serious? Oh, my God.
Remember that song go off?
Yes.
Detroit.
I'm concerned because there's something wrong.
Jesus. That's how my ass was, nigga.
God, I can't.
What?
I can't. Nigga, went back the next day and ate them again.
God damn.
They say the heart of rock and roll, dude. That was my ass was doing. And from what I felt, I believe them.
They called them Wolverine wings.
Boy, them wings are no joke.
Hilarious. Velcro-laced wings. Oh,
them wings come out, them look like them things. What's that latest Star Wars? What was them things? Rap-tarts?
What?
They had that Han Solo captured and they got loose on the
ship. Oh, yeah.
That's what them wings was like coming out my ass. Tasmanian Devil.
Imagine
the Tasmanian Devil.
Taint tussling. These niggas is going in.
Skid Mark Corey. You know fuck y'all niggas.
You know how you eat pizza and you burn the top of the ridge of your
rough,
mouth?
Yeah.
This shit was coming out your ass like that?
Oh, man, that shit, it fucked me up,
y'all
dog.
Ruined people.
So I be saying, I be like, what do gay niggas like about
that
this
and
shit?
Fried shrimp, too.
All right, now.
Fried shrimp make your ass do that?
No, but it'll tear up the top of your mouth.
Oh, yeah,
the roof of your mouth.
That's what happened to you? Hey, so, all right. Bubuic blood, for real. That's the shit.
I think we need to just get the experience out the way, Corey, so you'll be all right.
What do you mean?
Just have it done to you.
What?
Gimped. We need to have him gimped, and then he'll just be over, done, over, over,
what
and
the fuck
done.
What are you talking about?
Huh?
What are you talking? Wait,
Darlene's going directly
there. What are you saying? What are you suggesting? What are you saying?
Is that a hit?
He's saying he needs to get gimped.
Like on Pulp Fiction.
Just get it done.
Why would you even suggest some shit like that?
Because you're talking so much about a butt.
Darlene,
she's saying you have a fixation with ass.
Darlene is mad. Because
and not ass, assholes.
Darlene is mad because I believe, I'm just keeping it real.
You know what? You don't play fair.
Excuse me, I don't?
You can't bring up someone getting their ass banged out and I ask you a personal question and you can't answer it.
Because you don't know my history. They just told you that I wouldn't. But you can ask.
What about Gimp?
No, you can ask any questions you want. Knock yourself out.
But you won't answer.
We know your history, D, goddammit. We saw, what was the name of that movie? Ricochet.
What about
Come on, gal.
I was 8 months pregnant in that. Yeah.
No, you and old girl was fucking around.
What are you talking about?
Who?
The girl off Ricochet.
What?
You fucked the girl off Ricochet?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Come on.
He's trying to recover from it. Don't worry about it. It's okay.
Shame the devil.
Mm-hmm.
We about to get into the part of the show.
Oh, here we go.
That is called D's Loose Talk About Bullshit.
All right.
D, I know she got some good ones this week.
No, well, we'll see. I don't know. Anyway, the Olympics are happening.
Hey,
right?
Olympics.
Oh, yeah. Everybody coming back with AIDS.
U.S. Zika? The Zika?
Nah, the Zika. AIDS. Just straight AIDS.
Damn, you just went skip Zika.
Them hoes in Brazil got that package. They look good as hell, but when you be on the plane, you be
Grandma
like...
Grandma Green gonna come back scary as fuck.
Stop.
You saw that shit, so... Motherfuckers, you have fun while you down there, and then you be the fuck them hoes. You be on the plane, you be like, man, I can't wait to get back.
That's what y'all get.
You feel that shit.
Anyway, you know, there's a couple little
you
things...
You feel it like that? Like,
there's a couple little surprises to talk about, or stories to talk about for the Olympics. Anyway, but... Before we start and begin, congratulations to Phelps, right? He just won, what was it, his 21st
19th,
or something
20th,
like that? Yeah, 20th.
He gonna
record.
Have to pawn them niggas.
Oh.
The medals ain't gonna be worth
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, that's true.
Better pawn that shit.
Anyway, that just happened today. So, but I wanted to talk about Clarissa Shields. I don't know if you know who she is. They call her AKA T-Rex. You know who she is?
No.
Oh,
she's a middleweight. Oh, stop. There you go again, Corey. I wasn't gonna fall for that.
Right.
She's a middleweight fighter. Anyway, they call her T-Rex. She's the first female boxer to win back-to-back, hopefully, gold medals. And we'll find out when's her next fight. I think it's the August 17th is when she'll fight. But she's very young. What happened was back in 2012, they had just admitted women's boxing for the first time.
You bullshit.
Oh, here we go. Anyway, she came in at a really young age, 17. And she won. And then she wasn't supposed to win.
Oh, that's okay. Girl from Mom.
Shout out yes, to Million Dollar Baby.
From Flint. She's from Flint.
Yeah.
And anyway, so she won then, and then now she's back. So there, and here's the big thing, though. They put a documentary on her on Netflix, and it got so many great reviews that just recently Universal Pictures has obtained the rights by her team to put out like a Rocky type esque film on her story. So now she's got a film coming out for her. So we wish her well. I'm excited about it because I've been following her story. I saw the documentary. If you haven't yet, it's really good. It's about her.
She
looks
like an Alabama version of Serena.
Okay. This one is hardcore. Like, if you saw them next to you, wow. And she's made comments. You know what's really, like, standing out to people is that she made a comment about that she said if they paid her, I mean, she'd fight a Ronda Rousey. And I was like, have you seen how big this girl is? She'll
beat
girl.
The shit out of Ronda Rousey. She's too big for Ronda Rousey.
But she's trying to get that
right?
money, though.
Probably,
too.
Yeah.
She's trying to get money.
Ronda Rousey ain't finna fight. First of all, it's an MMA fighter, bitch. I don't
she's
know
got
if y'all
skills,
saw
though.
That. No, I'm talking about that big lady that can't find a fight. So she's really going to fight a man? Have you seen her?
I heard about that, but I haven't seen the girl.
It's a lady who fights MMA. No bitch will beat her. This bitch, for real, look like them things.
Like China did when China, you know how
what's
China.
Her name?
No, she's bigger than China. She looked like them things.
Bigger than China?
What's the that name of that huge. Movie that just came out? Well, old boy was like, if we combine our forces, we can beat them. It's a cartoon. It was a video game. It came out. Warcraft.
Oh, yeah.
She looked just like them things. And I'm not exaggerating.
You're saying this girl?
No, not her.
The one that he's talking about.
The lady I'm talking
find
about.
Somebody to fight.
I think she's in Brazil. Nobody will fight her, but nobody—you can't beat something like that.
No,
what's her
when
name?
I don't know that thing's name. Something. That lady was a fucking cyborg.
Can you look up something? Called,
is that her name, Cyborg?
No,
girl, your name, Cyborg.
Maybe.
Can you look it up on the internet?
Just anyway, back to Clarissa Shields, aka T-Rex. We wish
UFC
her well.
UFC female fighter who can't find a fight. That's what
you can't find
up.
An opponent.
Can't find an opponent, so she says she's going to fight a man. I believe if she fought like a regular sized dude, like or maybe like a what's not the smallest weight? What's the other weight?
Welter.
Not welter.
No, that's
she'll
really
bantam.
She'll get fucked up. Light? I'm talking about under welterweight.
It's like
maybe two. No, it's two under welterweight.
Bantam. No, that's
bantam. Bantam weight. No, they'll beat her ass.
I don't know, man.
I don't know.
If you see
a
this bitch,
bantamweight, they'll fuck her up.
If you see this
somebody
bitch,
somebody said it is Cyborg. That's the
oh,
girl.
That's her name.
Her name is Cyborg. Yeah, I seen who you talking about. No, because I saw her do a video where she choked out a journalist. He let
was saying,
her,
uh-huh.
But she got behind him and choked his ass out, put him out.
Mm.
Somebody said featherweight.
Chris Cyborg is her
you got
name,
a picture
yeah.
of the bitch?
Anyway, I hope homegirl wins again.
Yeah, because her story is rough. She
it is rough.
A, she
yeah.
come from she come from a rough ass.
Who the chick ran?
Yeah,
man,
and they were saying how that you know because
is that it right there?
Look at her. That's her.
Yeah. Ooh, she. Ooh. Her.
That's her.
Whoever that
that's
is.
That's Cyborg.
That's Cyborg. They call that one Cyborg. Chris Cyborg.
This bitch I'm talking about mm-hmm. is bigger than her.
Ooh, that's scary. Mm-mm-mm.
This bitch I'm talking about look like George Mirasan in them.
Oh, so she's a big, giant, tall Andre the Giant looking motherfucker.
This bitch look like a fucking. Who look like her?
God damn that bitch!
I'm gonna tell you who this bitch look like. It's an MMA fighter named Bigfoot. Show a picture of the MMA fighter Bigfoot. Bigfoot Silva, that's his name. This is who this bitch look exactly like.
She like she don't even wear tampons or nothing. She just
oh my goodness!
Just let it run.
That bitch, period, is oxtail muscles.
No, she might not even get any anymore. A lot of times when they're like when they're built like that, a lot of times they don't even get them anymore.
What?
Oh my God, that is not a real person.
That ain't
person.
No girl.
That is.
Think that's a real person. That's Bigfoot
oh,
Silva.
Oh, that's so scary.
Is that Nikki?
Huh?
That's Nikki.
Oh,
the bitch
God,
who I'm
God.
Talking about
I'm
look
done.
Exactly
I know,
like
that
him.
I caught like that. Nikki? Oh my God.
That's that giantism look. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Oh, that's what she did. Tony Robbins got. Tony Robbins had that shit where he
right where they developed
all
the
giants look like
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's how this girl look. And when she be punching, it don't even
well,
be fair.
That's not fair.
You
that's not
if
right.
she punch a bitch. Bitch, get the fuck out of here. You
well, they
down.
Need to let her. Let her fight that
like,
man.
Like, he got that disease mixed with Eli Manning.
Mm-hmm. I know what you're talking about. Even giant. Their voices are affected yeah. by it. Yeah.
Bigfoot Silva, that motherfucker, he used to be a good fighter in the MMA, but he be losing now.
All right. Well, wow. Well, we look forward to seeing a fight with this so-called cyborg person you're talking about. Scary. Anyway, so we wish a homegirl well. She uses her stipend, you know. She only gets $1,000 a month for the USA team, and she gives that all to her family for their electrical bills and her brother who's in
prison.
Okay,
let me ask you this. How much, you know this, how much do the athletes make that?
If they Olympics. If they don't get any sponsorship for like Wheaties and things like that, then their stipend is only it's $1,000
a month. You make you get paid $1,000 a month to go out here to compete for America.
No, that's just a given to you. But they pay for everything else, like your stay and your training and stuff like that. But that's all they get apparently in cash.
Get the
somebody
fuck
say
out of
that
here.
Bitch got Barkley wife disease.
Oh.
Oh.
Anyway, let's move on to other Olympic news. Anyway, I just wanted to say a big huge shame. Or F you really goes to that silly ass commentator. I don't know if you saw Al Totwig on NBC.
What'd he do?
Okay. He went out his way, and the reason why I say out of his way to refer to Simone Biles, that's her, that's him. When he was commentating, it was during the qualifications, and he referred to, now mind you, you don't know anybody else's situation with their parents or whatever, you know, like who's who, are they adopted, are they whatever. Anyway, he went out of his way to refer to her parents as her grandparents, even though technically, yes, they are biologically her grandparents, but she's always referred to them as her parents because they've raised her.
Right.
So he went out of his way to say, no, they are her adoptive, they're her grandparents. Yes, they may have
so
adopted
her. So basically
he was
just trying to shame her.
Exactly. Yeah. And and so
the
there you go. You got it.
Was he broadcasting in Brazil?
Yes.
I hope he catch whatever the fuck they got.
Oh, they're on him.
In his ass.
Look, they're on him. So
all
what happened was...
get it.
Yeah, all the people that are adoption shit. Advocates blew him up, right? So now he tried to apologize via Twitter, but then he just made it worse. He said they may be her mom and dad, but they are not her parents. He has since deleted it.
Which had nothing to do with what the fuck
at
he was
all,
talking
at
about.
Ever.
Talk about what she do. Fuck where she from. Mm-hmm. That bitch there competing.
And who took care of
and you there talking about motherfucking competing because you can't compete.
Right, and now it brought up. Now it brought up
your
the situation,
unathletic ass.
And now no, it, and now it brought up the situation that why they were raising her is because her parents are on you know on drugs.
That's what they were trying to do. Is
exactly,
trying to point out the fact that her parents were unfit.
Right,
that's okay though. He'll get
anyway. It's
he'll
so sad.
He'll get bald cancer.
Well, hopefully she can stay focused. Hopefully she can stay focused. But it is causing a big stir. I mean, they've been talking about it on all the news channels. Anyway, you can watch Simone and the rest of USA team compete.
They already
won
the gold.
No, but they're going to compete for the final, for the team final this Friday on all four events. So the balance beam, uneven bars,
they already got it. They winners. They already won.
So that's going to be exciting thing to watch on Friday.
You know, I am impressed about the fact that people matured up. Because you remember 4 years ago when Gabby participated,
right?
They clowned her about her hair. Like that was
so silly. That's the dumbest thing ever. Right?
They talked about this girl's hair.
She's a gymnast. Right. She's flying in the air.
She's talking about her hair.
She's gonna be sweating anyway. The shit gonna with any hairstyle she would have gotten would have fucking failed by the time she got to the goddamn arena.
Natural black hair nap up when it get wet. Leave the girl alone.
Show me your hair.
Oh, I ain't got no hair. You know what? Stop. You know what? Oh my god. Okay. So anyway, we wish the team well. We wish the team well. Poor Jesus. All right, so let's move on. All right, so, you know, there's going to be a lot more coming up. There'll be a lot more Olympic stories coming up. But for now, let's move on to another big story that's in the news. And that is, and that goes as of today. A lot of folks are talking about what Dwayne The Rock Johnson posted up on his Facebook and Instagram. It's causing quite
a
stir.
Oh, yeah, he shit on everybody that he was working with.
Anyway. As he's filming the last week of Fast and Furious 8, he posted this and has caused a little ruckus.
What'd he say?
He says, although he has gratitude for the hard work of the crew, the cooperation of the studio, and that he admired the endless professionalism of the female co-stars, that he didn't feel the same about his male co-stars. He said, some conduct themselves as stand-up men and true professionals, while others don't. The ones that don't are too chicken shit to do anything about it. To do anything about it anyway. Then he called them, they're all candy asses.
So basically what he's saying is, Vin Diesel is the last to work.
Wait a minute, what does candy ass mean?
That's what he used to say when he would fight, but he'd say candy ass.
Candy asses. So basically The Rock was like, Vin Diesel is cool to work with, Tyrese and Ludacris can eat it.
Well, no, we don't know who he's talking about. That's what's causing the big stir, is that he didn't specify any one, so now everybody's out there. What happened?
I believe that's what it is.
Oh, stop. But anyway, they said that Vin Diesel pulled a meeting together just to find out, like, hold on, what's happening? Because it's their last week of filming. This is what they claim in the news, that he said, hey, let's get down to the bottom of this. What's going on? Who's giving, you know, who's messing with
right.
you? Or who do you not like? Because now everybody's like, ooh.
Because you know they got to do two more movies after this one.
And probably, but
they got a deal in place. They're gonna do 10 Fast and the Furious movies.
God damn!
Well, let me say this.
The fuck?
I don't think
goddamn 10 car movies.
I don't think he's coming back, and I think he leaving talking shit instead of saying that shit while he was with them motherfuckers.
Well, he still is. They're on their last week.
The last week ain't that much to worry about.
Well, they still gotta do press together.
Your ass waited till you did some Hollywood shit, Rock.
It comes out next.
Why
year.
You talk shit? As y'all leaving.
Right.
That's some Hollywood shit, Rock. You a big motherfucker.
You a big nigga. You say what you want.
Tell them motherfuckers what you got to say.
Mm-hmm.
I've been on set with motherfuckers who did not conduct themselves professionally. I didn't say that shit after the last week or
you said it in the
when
very
we
beginning?
Was gone. No. Look, let me say something. If I don't say shit, it's because I'm going to tolerate this shit that's happening because there's a good reason to tolerate it. Sometimes motherfucker be the star of the movie. And they good people. It's just they got bad habits.
Mm-hmm.
I don't work with motherfuckers who cannot talk without saying the word nigga. Every time they speak, they be like, look, nigga, look, nigga, this, nigga. The whole time we film, and I just be like, nigga, this motherfucker crazy. Oh. He cannot not say nigga.
Wow.
You think I'm going to shit on him the last week we film? That's wrong.
You made it this far without saying nothing. Just let the shit go.
Right, because that's fucked up. Now that I'm going to get the fuck away from you, I can talk shit.
Right.
Come on, that's Hollywood shit.
Yeah. Well, we'll see. We'll see what that leads to. I thought before anybody started going,
he was calling white people niggas, though. That's how he talked.
Oh, the person you're talking about.
Yeah.
Okay.
He was like, look, nigga. But he talking to the motherfucking cameraman.
Mm-hmm. No, I was saying.
These niggas over here fucking up the shot.
Stop. No, he didn't.
What?
That's so unprofessional.
But that's him.
Okay.
He really that nigga.
Now we have
so
to find out who
that. I'm okay. Like, should he book this job like that? I ain't mad at him.
Anyway, I looked at it. I didn't even look at it like other people were looking at it. I looked at it like, oh, they're getting some press.
Look, it'll get press regardless. It's going to sell. All
right.
Controversy sells.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway.
Sell the movie.
All they right. don't. You think they really need to do anything else to help sell this fucking franchise? We got eight fucking movies of car chases.
And yeah. there's two more coming.
Eight.
The fuck?
How fast and how furious are these goddamn cars?
They ain't never said this shit, but that franchise fell off when Ving Rhames, I mean, not Ving Rhames.
Not Ving Rhames. Vin Diesel?
Diesel. When Riddick hit DVD and Vin Diesel was dancing with that straw in his mouth in his kitchen, I haven't been able to watch the shit no more.
What's you saying? So everybody else felt the same way, and they can't look at Fast and Furious. Look,
all real niggas who saw Vin Diesel in the kitchen with that straw.
What's wrong?
Doing a little jig.
Niggas, I don't know if niggas remember that shit. Did you see that shit, Chris?
He was doing the snake move like that? I gotta see this.
This nigga was in the kitchen with a straw talking about, hey, I'm happy.
Just put your head down.
Riddick came out on DVD. He was dancing the Beyonce song. What
the bell
song?
Is about to ring. Put your head down and rest your head.
What's the song with the tub?
Put your head down until the bell ring.
Wait, I thought you were talking about that was a part in the
Drunk
movie.
Drunk in Love.
Wait, he did it himself?
I thought he was in that motherfucker like. You see this shit?
You bullshit. You bullshit.
You ain't see that shit?
No.
Chris, get it.
Nigga, hunt that
bullshit down.
And when he talked, you could tell that moist shit was obvious. That nigga said.
What happens if Vin Diesel holler at you, though?
What Vin Diesel gonna do
please.
To me? Look.
Really, nigga?
Let me tell you something.
Tell me.
You might see me get my ass whooped because a motherfucker is a superior fighting ass nigga.
Right.
But, you going to see some shit that happened in that fight. Let me tell you something.
Wait, what's going to happen?
Uh-oh.
Let me tell you something.
I like this.
One day I was at the basketball court, and I probably said this shit.
Which one? Because I've been with you when you fighting.
This is when I lived in Chicago.
Uh-oh. Oh, Corey used to get in fight. We used to go play basketball at 24 all the time.
Yeah, we heard about
this is when I lived in Chicago. This one me fighting. This little kid kept shooting his ball, and he was fucking up the
game.
There it is.
He got the video.
Hold on. Of the nigga.
No, I can't
believe
this.
He got the video of the nigga.
Wait, can we hear it?
Can you play that shit now?
Wait, what?
Nigga, I ain't been able to watch this nigga for real since this. Watch this.
What in the hell is going on?
Watch this nigga. Hold on.
I'm about to be sick. Like
that guy, is that the one that look like the one? No, this is a remix.
Yes, it is. I hear Drunk in Love. I heard it. Ooh, he's touching himself.
Nigga, play what that shit. Play that shit at the break, nigga. Somebody say he looked like Mr. Clean.
I've never thought he was good looking. I don't like Vin Diesel.
Hey, man, cut that shit off.
This nigga like, you remember Signs of the Lambs?
If you
want to
play it during the break.
Oh, my God. That is ridiculous.
Somebody said, found it.
Stop.
Hey, man, when he was doing that shit, I was like, dog, a nigga just left his crib.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
Anyway.
But I seen this little kid. This motherfucker kicked his ball because he kept shooting it. Mm. Shorty got a brick and really threw the brick and hit that nigga.
Oh, yeah?
The nigga stood there like, what he going to do? That Shorty said.
Nigga did a hood David and Goliath.
Broke. Cause he can't whoop the nigga.
Yeah. Oh, so you say he gonna be the brick?
Man,
brick
look. Kid? If I can't whoop
lemon
a nigga.
Lemon pocket prince.
Nigga, lemon pocket
if prince. I can't whoop the nigga, everything go.
Oh, that's true. That's called
everything
go.
Everything go,
bro. That's me too, if you're protected.
I'll bite a nigga in a fight. You crazy? I'll bite a plug out of a nigga whooping my ass.
It's a liquidation sale, nigga. Everything got to go.
It's a liquidation sale.
Yeah, it's called go for broke.
Everything
got to
go.
You get in a fight with a motherfucker that you can't whoop.
Oh, man. Come on, man.
It ain't no rules then.
Right.
Take a nigga eye out.
I wish I knew this motherfucking song. It's this nigga. He's a dope fiend ass nigga from Chicago, and he wasn't funny on stage, but he had a funny ass song. And the song was, get that nigga off your ass in the way you can.
That was the name of the song?
That was the name of the
First
song.
First of all, he didn't make it because he don't know how to make short titles.
Oh. He said, bite that motherfucker. Scratch him in the jeans. Douse that motherfucker with a pot of hot grease. But get that motherfucker off your ass any way you can.
Oh,
y'all
my
niggas
God.
In the audience was dying.
Oh, my
it was,
God.
It was so whack, it was funny. He had a whole bunch of shit. Get that nigga off your ass any way you can.
Nigga. The longest title in any song like, hey, ever.
Yeah. If I'm fighting a nigga I know I can't whoop.
Yeah.
That's the rule, though. If you fight somebody that you can't beat.
Yeah, that's
get
true.
Get that motherfucker off that's your true. Ass in any way you can.
Okay.
How many people got hot greens just available, though?
Right. That's what when he said, douse that motherfucker with a pot of hot greens, we was like, douse?
You got hot greens in the car?
No, and if I'm fighting, it ain't going to be with somebody in the house.
A ham hock?
He said, douse that motherfucker with a pot of hot greens?
That is hilarious.
Sound like Crucial Conflict. Okay. Remember they got kicked out.
And he had that disease, them people who do this a lot,
Oh, Tourette's?
Yes.
Oh.
So when he said it, douse that motherfucker with a pot of hot grease.
Tourette's is the thing to make you.
And it makes sounds. You make weird sounds, too. Oh,
that's what that girl had in high school.
Oh. She might outgrow it because sometimes they outgrow it.
I thought that bitch was just nervous a lot.
Oh.
One day this nigga went on stage and he still had cocaine on his nose.
The same guy?
Ain't nobody say shit.
Just let the nigga play, just let him play through it. He'll figure
like,
it
what's
out.
Up?
Oh.
Uncle Abby. Niggas from Chicago know.
Oh my God.
Anyway.
All right, let's keep moving. Speaking about entertainment still, NBC has informed that they are not renewing the contracts of Jay Farrow, along with a few others on SNL.
Yeah.
Now, the other people that got let go have been speaking on it, and they are not happy. They're saying that they didn't give much notice and that they haven't been given a reason. So nobody's heard from Jay Farrow yet.
That's Hollywood, my nigga.
That's
well,
that's
if Jay Farrow speak, he'll use somebody else's voice, so we never going to get the real.
Yeah, Craig.
Yeah. What? The nigga does impressions.
That's true. He
my
does.
Nigga Jay Farrow.
That is true.
I'm sorry if you got dismissed.
He going to do it in Cat Williams' voice.
He going to get another lick, though.
Yeah, he will.
He'll get his own sketch show, whatever.
Yeah, he going to get another lick.
He'll be on like,
let me tell you why I like him.
He'll be on the gas station network.
You know who his manager is?
You going in right now.
You know what? Uh-oh.
You know who his manager is?
Who?
His motherfucking sister.
Okay.
And when motherfuckers told him, you can't use your sister, that motherfucker was like, fuck y'all.
Oh.
Him and his sister a unit.
Oh, that's
what you need, though.
There you go.
She watch his back. He watch her back. I love that shit.
Yeah.
That's good shit.
I love that shit.
That's family.
Yeah. That is.
That's a nigga from motherfucking...
Virginia.
Virginia, the slums, nigga.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I got love for any motherfucker who find a way. That nigga any was nigga on Saturday Night Live, nigga.
For 6 years. Right. That's a
if
good
one. If any nigga
run.
Can get out of Richmond, Virginia, God bless you.
No shit.
Via the internet. What was he? He started off on the internet?
I don't know. But if you get the fuck out of Richmond, even if you just walk.
They said he was discovered
out
from the internet.
Walk
to the next town. Huh?
If you just walk to the next town,
it ain't shit in Richmond, but motherfucking bottled water.
Well,
they be so happy to have that shit. They got some water from the bottle.
Like you said, he'll get another gig. Anyway, let's move it on. And congratulations to Will Smith and the rest of the cast of Suicide Squad. It brought in $267 million worldwide. $267 million worldwide at the box office
so
for
minions.
Opening weekend. It only cost $50 million to make.
That movie cost way more than $50
million.
They
said $50
million. Horse shit and bananas.
How do you know it cost more than $50
million? It cost way. Will Smith in the movie by itself is a $10 million check.
That nigga ain't hitting like he used to. That nigga took that $250,000.
Nope, I could have swore.
It's a hit for him now.
Yeah, I could have swore this.
He off the snide.
No, you never know.
I like the look. He got the beard with the no hair. That's good.
Yeah. Either way, it made $267 million opening box weekend worldwide. Haven't seen it yet, so I don't know. Didn't we just speak about this last week? This is so sad. I don't even know if I want to talk about this. We just spoke about how sad it is that we actually got to remind people about not leaving pets and kids in the car. Well,
what happened?
Well, here we go. This makes me so angry. Anyway, after we spoke about it last week about the nonsense of having to remind people about not to leave kids and animals in the car during the heat, well, I hope they lock this guy up, though. And his name is Asa North. You spell it
Asa.
I say Asa.
Asa.
It's ASA. I know, but I'm not feeling him. Yes.
Go ahead, Asa.
You
could
put his picture up. Anyway,
put his picture up.
Asa.
He's 24. He's the father of a set of twins, and they were left in the car for the very first time that he had ever watched their children by himself. The mom had to go out of town in an incident. Her sister was in a bad car accident, so she had to fly out of town. Anyway, he's 24. He and his uncle were drunk, and they pulled up in the front of their apartment building. You can look it up, right in Georgia. Pulled up in the front of the apartment building and just went inside. Left the two little baby girls, 15 months old. When he returned, he found him unconscious. Of course, he started, you know, the neighbors came out and they tried to help him revive him. But no, the cops showed up, of course. Now he's being charged with involuntary manslaughter and reckless conduct. The mother started a GoFundMe page to raise funds for the funeral. But after seeing her interview on the news, Tyler Perry said he'd cover the cost and that she can keep the $21,000 that had already been raised through the GoFund.
I will put that motherfucker in the car and leave him there.
And leave him and lock it up.
You think he did it on purpose?
No, they said that he was stinking. Drunk. Yeah, but still, him and his uncle.
But the crime fits the punishment. Put that motherfucker in the car in the heat, windows up.
Yeah.
In a Buick, nigga. Mm-hmm.
But look, just you have to be realistic.
I want you to die in a Buick.
If he was drunk, you stupid. He wasn't in his right mind. It seems like I'm making excuses for somebody, but I'm not. I'm just here to tell you. You cannot leave your motherfucking kids with nobody.
This was their dad.
How the fuck you forget your kids, though? She was together with him.
They were together. This is their dad.
First of all, why was he drinking with the kids in the car?
It's not an uncle. Both of them.
He never wanted the kids anyway.
You say, why was he drinking with the kids in the car? I'm trying to be serious for a second, not trying to cut nobody off.
Okay.
But if you know drunk motherfuckers.
They don't give a fuck. It's a sick. First off, it's a sickness.
You can't stop that motherfucker from being that motherfucker.
Right, it's a sickness.
Is she a drunk? Does she drink?
We don't know. I don't know.
That's what I'm saying.
If they're an alcoholic.
I don't know, but
she got babies by a drunk motherfucker.
Well, he was drunk with the kids, so I don't know his the whole spiel on him.
Man, drunk motherfuckers go hand in hand.
Well, either way. I don't know if he was drunk when she left the kids with him or not. I don't know. But
that nigga, he fucked up. He ain't gonna never be right.
Big time. But anyway,
he either gonna drink till he die now, or he gonna try to fix himself up.
Well, he can't drink. He's probably gonna stay in prison. I mean, they're dead. There's two little girls that are dead.
You think he finna go to jail?
Ah.
He got
they gonna lock him up. Initially, if he didn't intentionally murder them kids, I'm not making no excuses for this motherfucker. I just know what happens. That motherfucker gonna probably get in a program.
Yeah, because he was sick. It's a sickness.
This is what happens to them motherfuckers. Because them his babies. I don't think no motherfucker trying to kill
them
babies.
I would believe that if it was a white guy. I don't believe they're gonna do it for a black guy.
Well, it all depends on what kind of judge you get and shit.
And what state you in.
It don't matter what state. If he got a lawyer, look, let me tell you something. Ray Rice went to court, and that case was over. People who didn't like the way people reacted to what happened basically told the people who
extended the case on his
ass. They was like, make a new case for that nigga and kick him out the league.
Right. Yeah.
That's what happens, but I'm saying just regular shit. The courts don't give a fuck about your babies. Shit, the courts don't give a fuck about your baby.
Crown Royal Daycare, nigga.
Damn.
If you kill your baby,
oh, God.
It's different.
God,
if he would have killed somebody else's babies, I believe he would have been trialed differently. But when he in there, sobering, sad, fucked up.
Oh, because he going to be fucked up. When it come to him and he understands.
I hear you, though, Corey. Listen.
He's going to kill himself.
He might kill himself.
That's what I'm saying. He going to do some jail time just because.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying what be happening with these cases, man. Don't nobody give a fuck about us.
No, they let him go, too, though. But even the white folks that have done it, they actually beat it because they go, well, it was an accident. It wasn't meant to be.
I know what happened in court.
Yeah.
Niggas get in trouble where a whole bunch of people who got power don't want the nigga to not get in trouble. Ray Rice got trialed, sentenced, and everything. Then it came out what happened, and they fucking made it where that man is motherfucking selling newspapers probably.
Mm-hmm.
I'm joking. I don't know what he's doing, but he ain't playing in the NFL. I know he offered to play for free, which is pretty desperate.
That was desperate because that's pretty much him saying, look.
I will donate my whole contract.
Just let me get back in the league.
Right.
That's it.
Well, let me finish on a somewhat funnier note, I guess. This is a very interesting story, and this might I want to see what you got to say about this, Corey.
Arbor Miss Nursery.
God damn it. These niggas.
Anthony Daycare, nigga.
Let me know.
Damn.
Boone's Farm Daycare. Okay, I'm sorry.
Hell gonna be crowded as a motherfucker.
I don't want to talk over. So
go ahead.
Okay. Anyway, this story is about the passing of Leroy Black. Now, nobody really knows who Leroy Black is, but he's a New Jersey man who passed away last week due to lung cancer. Well, His wife and his longtime girlfriend both placed dueling obituaries. So they're making the rounds with this story because people are just having a field day with this. They placed dueling, what they call dueling obituaries, because they were placed next to each other in the same newspaper. They were placed in the same newspaper, the Atlantic City Press, and also, they're right next to each other. Do you have that picture, Chris? Anyway, so one of the obituaries says, of course, it's the one placed by his wife, says survived by his wife, his son, and two other children. And then the other one is by his girlfriend, and it gives him even a nickname. It says Leroy Blast Black Blast. And it does mention the children, but not the wife. Instead, it says survived by his longtime girlfriend, Princess Hall. Leroy was 55 and he died of lung cancer from fiberglass exposure from his job. And they also have on there, if you can see, it's too blurry there, but if you look them up online, they actually are having two services for him. This past Saturday, the wife had hers, and then the girlfriend had hers on the 7th. No word on how they all went.
Let me tell you something about that.
It's like, did you only see him? Poor Leroy. Look at Leroy. He's a player.
To those who are unrepresented, let me remind y'all what happened when that dumb bitch started talking about the owner of the Clippers, because she thought she was scot-free. She thought she had that paper and everything. His wife took the shit to the courts and said that belongs to the marriage. Uh-huh. She's not supposed to have that. So now that bitch out here popped off broke because you thought you was about to put that man on the spot. I mean, he was a racist motherfucker, and she knows he was a racist motherfucker when she was fucking him.
Give all what I'm that saying, back.
Mm-hmm. She thought she had a Bentley because they made her give back the Bentley.
All that.
The shit.
Condominium, all that.
You can only do that to the unrepresented. What's happening right there. Because if that bitch had money.
King Cobra.
Especially if she was white with money. That bitch who put that obituary in the paper mm-hmm. would probably be locked the fuck up. Because you have no right to do that.
Right.
You don't have a legal right to do that. How the fuck you going to put it? That's his wife. That's who going to get any money from what happened to him at that job if it ever come. Right. I bet she signed the death certificate.
Right.
Who is this bitch?
Right.
We don't, you know what I'm saying?
To do some vicious shit to put an obituary in the motherfucking paper without, and on top of that, basically on some spice shit where she didn't say the wife.
Right. But here's the thing. We don't know if it's in some spice stuff. Now, what if he had an ongoing, what if they all knew? A lot of times these families know, oh, that's dad's girlfriend. He been with her. We don't know the details, the depth of it.
Well, this is what made me
but
feel
that's
like,
a lot of nerve. Do you know what I'm saying?
This is what made me feel like everything wasn't up front. Because that bitch didn't put the wife. She said survived by this. That's some spiteful shit.
That's true. Survived by his longtime girlfriend.
Longtime girlfriend. What? Bitch, I'll come out the grave for a bitch on some shit like that. I'll be like, bitches, you out here starting shit because I'm dead?
Because I'm dead.
You're supposed to be dead. I'll be in that bitch house. Ooh. Your ass out of here, bitch.
Anyway,
my family
alone,
ho.
Anyway, that was bad.
I say this really quickly?
Yeah.
Rest in peace, Dr.
That's true,
Sabi.
Leroy. Dr. Okay.
Legendary herbalist.
Didn't I meet him on your show?
Yes, you did. He was on the show, and, you know, what motherfucker happened? Was 80-something years old. Herbalist, healing motherfuckers. Healing AIDS, healing herpes. Healing. Won a court case. They been fucking with him.
I remember that. When did he die?
And then they found him. He had like $37,000 worth of cash on him. They locked him, put him in jail, and then he died.
Really?
Yeah.
They killed him.
That's
what people are saying. That's what the word
so
on the street
really
is.
Really, just listen. You know, there's an old African proverb that says, when an old man dies, a library is burnt down. That man has so much knowledge for our community, for who we are, for him to be taken out or go out that way, it's disrespectful to our people.
There's
so
no fear of killing us. If you know the true story of what happened to Prince, you know he was murdered.
I mean, shit.
My gut tell me, oh, they just murdered him.
Prince, Michael Jackson, Dr. Sabi, and on.
There's no
Jimi Hendrix.
There's no
on
repercussion.
And
on. For murdering us or talking shit about us on TV.
Right. None.
Like Stephen A. Smith and Charles Barkley and They know that nothing's going to happen to me if I talk shit about black people.
I mean, and it's very
suspicious. If you kill a black person and you in front of a judge and you not black, they feel bad for you.
Right.
You shouldn't go to jail. I'm going to make your sentence as light as possible.
Right.
But if you black and you kill somebody, especially not black,
you going to jail.
You better get your escape route together.
Right. They give it. Listen, just listen to the logic behind it. You got some judges giving people 147 years, 100 and this many years, 87 years. The average motherfucker don't live till 70 something. So they still giving out these exorbitant sentences, and usually it's to black folk. I'm not saying white folk don't get long sentences, but I'm saying typically you see black people, black men in particular, getting these elongated ass fucking sentences.
Do you
sentences.
Agree with this?
The shit is crazy.
You say you don't see, you see white people getting long sentences
too,
right?
Some of them. They got to be. So, well, that's if they ain't considered crazy. Like the Dylan boy.
Or
the Dylan
boy. Dylan
boy
or
get to be seen as crazy for walking into a church and gunning down nine people while they praying.
He just got the shit beat out. He just got the shit beat out of him this week.
It was good. He needed that ass whoop.
He got the shit beat out of him in jail.
He needed that.
They fucked him up.
Mm-hmm. Shit, that's part of his justice.
But he gonna go, I bet you he won't get executed.
Probably won't.
He won't get executed.
Bottom line is.
You say he won't get executed in jail?
No, he'll probably die in jail. Someone will kill him in jail, but the government or the state, like, death penalty for him, that ain't going to happen.
They're going to protect him.
They're going to study him.
He's sick. Mm. He's sick.
You talking about the guy who shot up the church?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're going to protect him.
He's sick.
If he's in general population, he's going to die.
Listen, motherfucking Charles Manson is still alive.
Hello.
Because he's considered crazy and sick.
Mm-hmm. And they make money off him because they do documentaries on this motherfucker every 2 years.
Right. Who did he kill?
He didn't.
No, he didn't.
Yeah. He was a cult leader.
He was the cult leader that sent his people out.
He was L. Ron Hubbard of Massacre.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Who did he kill?
He crazy, though.
He told white people folks. To kill people.
Yeah, his people killed white folks.
You hear what I'm saying? D, you caught on what I'm saying.
Yeah. I know where it was done. There's two houses right there. I could take you where the LeBlanc murder.
If he was killing black folks, he wouldn't even be in jail. He'd be out right now.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like Zimmerman.
Yeah.
And most of the people that did
and all the cops who killed black people who are unarmed.
That ass whoop too.
And those people that actually
did
it are out.
He just got his ass beat this week too.
Let's get that ass.
Yeah. If he ain't dead, justice ain't done.
And two of those women are out.
I mean, I commend the dude who beat Zimmerman ass or whatever happened, but it's some men out here who, in my opinion, need to be changed. I'm just saying. Motherfuckers need to be changed.
Need to be rearranged is what you want.
You ain't got to say all that. Just say they need to be changed. Mm-hmm. Everybody who motherfucker know what's up, everybody who count know what that mean, need to be changed. It's a goofy motherfucker who be on the internet and he talks shit about black women.
Who?
This goofy motherfucker. I ain't got to say his name. Because enough people out there know who I'm talking about.
Yeah, that's true.
You know he a sissy. Oh, yeah. That's what all I say there. He a sissy. But he love talking shit about black people. How can he be around any group of black people after saying what he said? Because, see, if you have a problem with somebody, like a black woman in particular, or something that happened, because I've had problems with black women. But I'm not finna say, all black women this, like this motherfucker do. He shit on black women.
Who the fuck?
We don't like
we call him the sissy mayor. Yeah, fucking, I ain't scared.
No,
what
are
he gonna do when
just,
he see me?
We just don't like giving him any.
All right, we'll find out.
But this punk ass nobody, nigga, he talks shit about black women. And I just say to myself, okay, so how is he still having a heartbeat? If that's his whole thing, we saw him on camera talking tough to a black woman. Never seen him talking shit to a black man face to face. Maybe on his show, when he get on his show, hey y'all, how y'all doing? Woo, 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 woo. Yeah, motherfucker, ain't nobody around. Talk that shit when a nigga in front of you. I ain't never seen him do that. But these motherfuckers roam the earth. Charles Barkley, Stephen A. Smith. These motherfuckers
Larry Elder.
take pride in talking shit about black people. But
Stacey Dash.
Stacey Dash. But them motherfuckers still walking around. And but I don't get it.
I think she blocked me on Twitter.
I don't get it.
I think black people talking bad about other black people is a conduit to success. Especially when it involves the media.
When you're of not, course. When you're non-threatening.
Yeah, you know, you can talk shit about other black people and then
that's how you get TV shows.
They'll be like, oh, okay, this is one we can elevate. Mm-hmm.
That's how you get shows on NBC.
Of course. And that's what I said. We know you do it because there's no repercussion for doing it when you're around on the other side. But what about when they be around niggas?
Oh, yeah, Sheriff Clark, too.
Woo!
That Sheriff Clark ain't going to never be around niggas. And if he is, he going to have on that shit. Police uniform with his pistol.
Thank you for that shout out. I forgot about that motherfucker. Yeah. I knew I was heated about him.
He got a gang.
He got a gang. Listen.
He's the sheriff, and he got a gang.
Won't nobody take that motherfucker down.
Well, it's motherfuckers who would take him down.
He's supremely confident in talking shit because he's the sheriff of a town, and he's got a gang. Mm. Let's just keep that clear. He's supremely confident.
What's it? Wait here. He in Texas, right?
He in Milwaukee.
Milwaukee?
He make me want to go to Milwaukee.
No, you don't want to go to Milwaukee.
You'll be in jail.
I believe it.
Getting the shit.
It ain't even just that.
You been to Milwaukee before?
Ain't nothing in Milwaukee.
I'm from Chicago.
You seen that fucking Civil Rights Museum they have? It's like big as this fucking room?
Man, look, I'm from Chicago. I've been to Milwaukee. And there's some motherfucking niggas in Milwaukee who bout that life. But everybody is, we not on the right page. We not guided the way we need to be guided, so when we see the enemy or when we see the coons, we make sure they pay for being the enemy or the coon. That's all I'm saying.
Right.
We don't know how to do that because we that safe group that think that
we forgiving.
Oh, you're not supposed to be violent to them, even though they violent to you.
Mm.
They'll murder you, but the coon in charge in this country went on TV and said, oh, that's not the way to do it. The way to do it is to vote. See, you got me in office. And what the fuck he do? Not a motherfucking thing. Never said nothing aggressive against the people that he know are killing unarmed black people. And when he did say anything about it that was against it, he had beer with the white boy who killed that mother. I mean, who took that man to jail for burglary in his house.
And let me say this too.
Mm. I'm just putting it out there. And what it is. You got motherfuckers who, look, it is a sister in Baltimore who her job is on the line.
Talking about the mayor, right?
Oh, no.
Not
no,
that
no,
mayor
no.
coon, bitch. I'm talking about the other lady.
The,
I think she's the, is she the?
District attorney or
district
something
attorney.
Like that?
Let me see. I can't think of her name.
I know you're talking about. I got
the
her
one we
right
spoke
here.
About last week?
I don't know if we spoke about it last week, but she.
I got her right here.
Is under attack. By all of the racists.
Because she calling them out on their
shit. Caucasian people.
Marilyn Mosby.
Marilyn Mosby.
That's the one we talked about because the cops that got off are suing her now.
5150 Nation. Please reach out if you get an email or Twitter, anything, and send that sister your support. Because the racists, Caucasians in power, do not like the fact that she didn't take the Obama route and blame the people.
Right.
She got at them racist-ass motherfucking officers and them coon-ass officers who murdered that young man and tried to get him locked up. Mm-hmm. But there's so many racists in power, they basically are going above her head mm-hmm. and making the law what they want to make the law to be. Mm-hmm. So that sister is a real soldier.
Right.
Do not, that her name should be written in stone in this war we having against all these racist motherfuckers. That sister, I love you, sister, because I know what you up against in that office. You work with them racist motherfuckers, and you choose to do the right thing instead of getting on board with them like this coon-ass motherfucker in charge is.
Yep, Judge Olu Stevens just got shut down for standing up against the system.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He got shut down for 90 days. When is the last time you ever heard of a city council shutting down a judge?
A white judge let this white boy off for rape.
Yeah, I'm going to give him 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
Stanford.
Rape.
Wealthy. They even come up with shit like, oh, he suffers from
affluenza.
He's so rich. Privileged and so rich
he
can't possibly know what the real world is and what right and wrong is.
Somebody on there said all white folks ain't bad. I didn't say all white folks are bad.
We're just talking about the disparaging injustice.
What I said, so it can be out there, racist white motherfuckers are my enemy. Put that on a motherfucking t-shirt. Don't get me confused, because I know what the fuck I'm talking about.
And if that ain't you, then you don't fall in that line. So
let me throw something else out there really quickly. Like, you have to understand that there are obvious problems with the American system in terms of racism, in terms of injustice. So to be pro-system when you black is to really root for a racist system. So when we look at racism in America, we can't first start with white people. We have to first start with the black people who support the system. That's the, like, when you say calling them out, it's calling them out, isolating and insulating the motherfuckers away from us.
But Zoe, let me tell you something.
We have to do that.
Not only calling them out. If you want to fix it, you have to set an example so the other coons know.
Right.
This is what happened if I coon and turn against my own. Do you get what I'm saying?
Right.
You can't just say he be cooning. You got to change them niggas.
Right.
You got to change them. Then, once people know, there is repercussions to doing this shit. Hmm. The police not going to stop killing unarmed black people because ain't no repercussions to it.
No.
But if you stop the head.
Right.
Oh, man, they killed so-and-so. They killed our chief. Mm-hmm. They killed this. I'm not saying that's how motherfuckers go about it. You don't just go. You have to be organized. Hmm. You can't just see the one dudes who go out there and do their thing. They separated. There is no, it's not a lot of people who gonna have the courage to go on TV and say, I understand why this brother did this. It's hard being black at this time in this country because we watch our people die unarmed.
That won't get televised.
That's what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm saying. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They won't even let it be said on television.
Right.
They don't want people to even think like this.
If you tweet that shit, they'll take it down.
I mean, because if you go back, okay.
Well, I tweet a lot of shit. I'm shocked I still got that pussy ass Twitter. Corey Oakham, by the way. They going to get me one day. I don't give a fuck.
I always go back and I look at Malcolm. Malcolm died at the hands of black folk. Only because black folk are willing to take a check from the system. They're willing to sell out our own to get up over in this system. So at the end of the day, we got to renounce, right, their way of doing things. And we have to take ownership of our way of doing things, create a way. But it can't just be, okay, let me sell this nigga out so I can come up. When Malcolm died, I don't care who did it. I don't care who's responsible for it. Oh, the FBI, CIA, the Nation of Islam, whatever. Somebody took a check where black men went
killed
another black man.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the day, we got to take motherfucking responsibility for that. The black men in our society who will take a check to turncoat on another fucking black man. Let me tell you something. Nobody that listens to this show will find themselves in the position that Corey or myself, Maranzi or D, puts themselves in every week. We talk that real and to a mass amount of people that elevates who we are, that puts us in harm's way. Nigga, being at the crib listening to what we talking about, you safe. We not safe talking the way we talk.
Not right now.
We get the attention yo bitch ass couldn't weather. You couldn't handle the attention we get.
Well, you know,
because
what?
Because we real enough Zoe's to speak saying. On that.
Let me say this about what Zoe's saying, because what he's saying is absolutely correct, and I just want to break it down another way. Going on the motherfucking chat room, going on the internet, and sending niggas shit that you see that are injustice is done to us is different than when Zoe do it, I do it, because I know I'm under surveillance. I feel it. I know they watching me. I know everything I tweet out is a motherfucker like this. Writing that shit down, who worked for some agency. I don't know when they gonna come get me, but I don't give a fuck no more. I'm old. I ain't no elderly nigga, but I done did a lot of shit, more than I ever thought, coming from motherfucking Robert Taylor Holmes in Illinois. So I ain't scared of shit when it really boiled down to it. I don't want nobody to fuck me up. I saw how Malcolm X got killed. I was like, God damn, that's what the fuck gonna happen to me? But it ain't gonna stop me from being who I am, because I promise you, I'm this nigga to a fault. So, when, like I said this shit the other week. When motherfuckers send shit about these bitch ass niggas, look, when that bitch ass nigga come to your town, if you ain't got the heart to step to that motherfucker and at least say what's on your mind, don't send me shit. Because you ain't on that level of doing something about it. I'm telling you, man, look, certain rappers, when they come to certain cities and they be done said the wrong shit, niggas be at they ass. Niggas be right there at the show waiting for them to get off. Like, hey, homie, what was that shit you said about woo, 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 woo? I feel like it should be that way when you got gay niggas talking about black women. And y'all know who I'm talking about. When that nigga is around you, it is your duty to be like, hold up, there go that nigga who was talking that shit. Hey, my nigga, so what you say about black women? What's your problem with black women? Mm. I ain't saying you supposed to put your hands on them. I'm not saying that. But when you see how much of a bitch this nigga is, you're going to be like, you was talking all that shit and you done pissed on yourself, because that's all he going to do, because he not cut to deal with a man. He cut to talk shit from a safe spot on the internet about a woman, or if he get in a traffic accident with a woman, he'll talk crazy to her. But if he was in an accident with a man, he'll be like, oh, it's all good, man. Good. And people know what I'm talking about, because he had that accident with that lady, and I'm not saying that lady right. I'm not saying he right. I don't know everything, but I know when he was talking that shit, it was because it was a woman. Mm. I don't believe that he'll talk that shit to a man like that. Not that bitch-ass nigga that I met and looked in his eye when he came in here. I looked at that bitch-ass nigga. I don't believe you talk shit to a man. Just like that man said in Mississippi Burning. What'd he say? I don't believe I'll ever be convicted in the state of Mississippi. Remember he said that shit? With all the confidence in the world. Ain't no jury gonna motherfucker convict me in the state of Mississippi.
Nigga,
I don't believe that nigga talk that shit to no man. Though. I don't believe he'll talk no shit to no man. Unless it's a real little man. He might talk shit to you, Maranzio, but he ain't gonna talk that shit.
Tattoos.
No regular size man. Anyway.
Complain. Boss.
Hold on. This nigga came on your show?
Bitch ass nigga came on my show. But look, it was motherfuckers sending me shit about this nigga. But I didn't know him. They was like, man, you let that bitch ass nigga come on your show? But I didn't know. I was like, man.
And he hate black women?
Man, this motherfucker talk shit about sisters like they ain't shit.
Oh, this nigga a whole nother level of ain't shit.
Yeah. But anyway, we got to wrap for a break. When we come back from the break, we're going to try to change the mood and make the show happy again. It's just, it ain't a lot of happy shit happening in the world, but we're going to make the motherfucking world happy tonight.
Rest in peace, Dr. Savy.
That's Dr. Savy, brother, I met you at Zoe's show. Respect, man. I don't know what happened, man, but it fucks with me thinking about somebody put their hands on you when you was 83 years old and they was mad because you was a motherfucking messenger who had gifts for the people. I heard about people curing herpes before, though.
He just had a baby 2 years ago. When he was on my show, he was like, yeah, I just had a baby.
So he was 80 with a baby on the way.
Come on, man. He was like, shit, my shit wasn't working when I was in my 30s and I had to create something. And he started getting into the herbs and healed himself first and then started healing people. I mean, of course, you know about Lisa Left Eye Lopez went down there and she made sure that she elevated him to where everybody knew about him. He worked with Michael Jackson. He worked with a lot of people, man.
And
won court cases.
Anyway,
we should do a blog about who he was, you know, your version of who he is, Zoe. Because I know you know him. He came on your show. Dude. But anyway, we'll be back. We finna take a break. 5150, motherfuckers. We'll be back in about 10 minutes. Maybe 15. 10 minutes, though. Mm.
This is a DJ Sid exclusive.
Yeah. Mm, yeah. Baby. This is the story of what happens when couples finally make it to that level where they respect each other and things are going the right way. You know what I'm saying? It's been a long time since I called you a bitch, baby. It's been a long time since I called you a bitch. You a bitch. Listen, girl. Baby. All these years together has made our bond so much stronger, yeah.
Strong, bitch.
Since you start taking baths before you get into bed, the love making it last a little bit longer.
Little bit longer.
Little longer, bitch. Listen, them nights you went to the club. And stayed out all night with your friends.
Yeah.
Me and the girl off Backpage. We babysat the kids again. So help me.
Babysat the kids again.
Been a long time.
Baby.
Since I called you a bitch. Take your glasses off of this part. Been a long time, yeah. Since I called you a bitch. Tell them so.
It's been a long time since I called you a bitch.
Tell them why.
Yeah.
You've been getting out of hand for a while now. So I had to send your son to go and get me a switch, baby.
Get a switch.
Pick it out yourself.
Tell him so. Come from the heart.
Now all you had to do was cook good food, clean my clothes.
Oh.
And give good head in a pinch.
In a pinch, bitch.
In a pinch.
But now you're gone and got full of yourself.
How dare you?
So I gotta sit your stankin' ass on the bench.
Sit
on the bench.
Oh, it's been a long time.
Oh, since I called you a bitch, baby.
Hey. It's been a long time. Hey.
Too long.
Since I called you a bitch,
baby.
Listen. When your family came over to kick it that summer, and your funky ass wouldn't make my plate.
Oh, shit, you need to be checked.
I kept my composure, and I didn't spit in your motherfucking face. Been a long time. Since I called you a bitch. I don't want to do it, baby. Been a long time. Since I called you a bitch.
Too long.
I don't like talking to you like you're from that part of town.
But every now and then.
But sometimes I got to clown. Hey.
Got to go down.
Since I started going upside your head and you were scared, we ain't had no problems. Our drama is dead. Trauma dead.
Drama's dead.
Hey, been a long time.
You know you gotta get checked.
I called you a bitch.
Every time I check you, you get more and more beautiful.
Heifer. 5150, motherfucking.
Hey!
Thank you. Do that laugh again.
I feel like I'm dying on the inside.
How you chop it up with it?
You sound like the Joker laugh at the end of Batman.
Oh shit.
Hey, you got it. Can you go real slow with it, Chris? You can only go.
Look what this man did to Marazzi.
Hey. You got the slow sound? Not the real giggle laugh, the other one. You ready?
Got me looking like Arthur out this bitch.
When Darlene and Ice-T make up, he hitting them from the back. It's going to sound like this.
Nigga, that's horrible.
Colors.
Nigga, are you really drinking a goddamn beer?
Nigga, I'm a weirdo, nigga. The problem with beer, you got to drink it fast in order to get a real buzz, because they don't make this shit like it used to be. They used to make them 40s. Boy, you drink half that motherfucker, you be like, indeed. You bitch! Shut the fuck up! Look at this shit watered down. I don't even want this shit.
You're a real bitch, you son of a bitch!
Yeah, it ain't cold like it was when I first
bought it. Oh, my God.
That's great. Fucked up.
That was great, you guys. That was
finally did another song.
We needed to do another song.
That song was good.
I felt
it. We just got to put the lyrics together one day.
You felt that? Yeah, nigga.
Moronzi held
5 heartbeats.
He had on the scarf.
That's all I had, nigga. Wardrobe was slim.
Oh, my God.
I know y'all like my jackets. Somebody say, wait a minute. Somebody drinking Snickers beer. Fuck you, nigga.
Fuck. Hops, barley, and
you're not the only
chocolate.
One that got the laugh.
What?
You're not the only one with that laugh.
You know what? I'm going to tell y'all some real shit. I was eating them Cheetos, right? So my fingers was fucked up.
Oh, I thought you about to say something else.
So I didn't want to pull my drawstring in the bathroom. So I got on short, so I peed from the bottom.
This is straight fat struggles right here.
What, nigga? You mad because you can't pee from the bottom, motherfucker?
What?
So I peed from the bottom.
I'm concerned because there's something wrong.
I forgot I got on white drawers. So I noticed Cheeto juice finger touched my white drawers, and it's going to look like I'm bleeding.
What's wrong with this? What's going on?
I know that shit. I hate that shit.
Nigga said I peed from the bottom.
Right.
You ain't never peed from
and
the bottom?
I got Cheeto stains on my fingers, and I touch my drawers so it'll look like I'm bleeding.
You could have washed your hands.
What?
I tried to wash my hands, but it was still Cheeto shit on my hand.
Yeah, but you got black on, so it's okay. We wouldn't be able to.
The drawers are white.
No, but you were afraid to touch the top of your pants and the drawstring because you had the Cheeto juice. Is that what you
right, mean? It would have fucked up. It would have been up here. By the way, everybody, this is my new shirt.
Bad built chicks who brag about being faithful never had a choice anyway.
Nigga, that might be the most hateful shirt I've ever seen in my life.
You wear this shirt out in public, people be like, what are you saying?
If you don't get your Amana stove built, get out of here. I'm just saying.
I
got no
faithful
choice.
To you. But you better be faithful to me.
It's going
to
be a woman to take Corey out.
You fuck big
your
slow bitches.
Minivan built ass out of here and just cook up something for us.
Bitches with this shit? Well, when bitches with this shit ride dick, boy, you talk about feeling like a man. Them bitches be up there like, oh, boy, them bitches who got this retard. It's different types of retard.
But is it good cooter in there?
Sometimes
in a,
it's
in
good
a
cooter.
Bad built
Sometimes
bitch.
It's good cooter. Darlene has on another one of our new dresses. This is the main Ooh. Chick dress. A lot of people buy them for their girl. Stand in front of the chair. Says main chick. But look, I got bigger sizes this time.
That's why it's so big is it's an
extra large. That's an XL Darlene has on. But it stretches real good.
We got
other colors. We go all the way up to 3X. We got 1X, 2X.
Brother Jay said.
And 3X.
Yum.
What happened?
I'm
just
saying.
We got different
saying.
Colors. We got the pink and green. We got the pink dress with
Angus
the pearl.
Angus ass.
God damn it. We, nigga, look, let me tell you something.
Y'all bodies right now. Let's
One
go.
Thing I found out about women's clothes. When dudes come out to the show, if they lady like the dress, they will break themselves to buy the dress.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And I got to take that money, homie, because she going to get it.
Might as well do your thing now.
What happened? No, those are the dresses. Those are dope. We got different colors. But listen, what y'all don't understand, my site, CoreyHokum.com, we add stuff every week. I got some dope ass, what would you call those things? Jumpsuits?
Yeah, they're jumpers. Like a jumper. It's a jumpsuit type.
This thing got a clothing line.
I got some. Yeah. That's right. I got some dope ass jumpers that's going to be put on the site. It might not be up till Saturday.
Yeah,
but check my site like once a week or something like that. See what I got new on that motherfucker because I got some new shit and I finally got my shit. My store is starting to run efficiently.
Efficiently.
That's a big word.
No. It's not.
Up tonight, right?
Right, these are going on. Are they on already?
You're on. I'm just going to hit the switch. But this
hit the switch now.
Shit, hit it now.
But, oh. Like I said, this was an extra large and it's very stretchy. So even if you're, you know, like a medium.
Ladies, these are the type of dresses you wear with no drawers on.
Or
right?
J-string.
Be accessible. Right.
You know, that little pull to the side action.
All you bitches who wear that, what's that body magic shit? Spandex. bitch be in the club. Built
body
like
magic shit.
They are spandex, stretchy.
Yeah, those are kind of stretchy, but then we got up to 3X. This so, bitch, if you here. Know you're a 3X, or I mean, if you're a 5X, bitch, this is all I'm saying. And this ain't no joke. I done seen bitches cut dresses into some magical shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was this girl who worked at this store, Affliction, and she turned these T-shirts into dresses, and it was amazing how mm-hmm. she had that shit set up where it was this thing where she cut the back out where you could tie it, so it turned into literally a dress. Mm. I was very impressed. I wish that bitch could come work for me, but Affliction pay. God damn it, I got that work with me ass check, you bitch. They're up, D?
There it is. Right, D just made up. It work.
All you moist-ass niggas, I'm going to start coming out with moist nigga gear.
Moist nigga gear.
Like man stretch pants. Niggas be wanting to show other niggas they thick. I know I'm going to kill them in Atlanta when I go to Atlanta with this shit.
This nigga called them coiroids. Coideroids.
Coideroids.
Whoa. Good job, Darlene.
It was a lot because Amazon on their Audible is really strict. But anyway, I got it out, so it's out. But I wanted to give some codes away because I got 25 to give away. And so I'll be posting up some stuff on my social media for a little contest and stuff here and there.
So she teased us on the 5150 show.
That's all right. She does it
every week.
Shit on audio, it's like
she does it every week.
$6 to $8.
Who talking?
It's me.
You talking through it?
I read it. Yeah.
That's what's
dope.
Up.
Oh. Congratulations,
like X-rated narration one day. God damn it. Like, commentate. I think as the 5150 show, we should commentate two people fucking.
Fuck it right in the pussy.
Now, see, right here, he's going to lift up her leg.
Two people fucking, and we just give our commentary.
Oh, wait a second. Can I say something?
Yeah, she's juicing off real good right now.
Take that, you bitch.
A story a month ago, and we went overtime or what have you, but they, you know that there's some porn company who.
Is your mic off?
No.
Okay, go ahead.
Somebody said D fixed Darlene, or Corey, or Chris fixed Darlene's mic. That's
it says
what somebody
it's off.
Said.
Said it was off. Oh, there it is. Anyway, there's a porn company who has put out porns for
Christian porn?
people that can't see. So they go over all this detail. I swear to God,
what,
I was going to talk about
web,
it.
Christian porn is like called Hallelujah.
No, but I was going to talk about it a month ago.
Are you serious?
I think we should commentate a porn.
But that's what it sounds like.
That would be hilarious.
I just think we should commentate a porn
It sounds as like
the 5150 show.
That shit would be hilarious.
And we come with our own opinionated commentary as two people fuck.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh yeah, there we go.
Anyway,
we're gonna have we're gonna have Portis come watch.
Damn you, Moronzo.
She can steal the nut from the motherfucker.
Moronzo's stealing my laugh. All right.
Who else I be forgetting to talk about that I be wanting to put
oh
up?
Oh, my God.
Who did I forget? I feel like I'm forgetting somebody.
You hit Charles. You hit Charles.
We used to talk
everybody.
About Porters and who else?
We got everybody.
I feel
yeah,
like
got
I'm
everybody.
Forgetting somebody.
No, anyway, I don't think you so. Got I think everybody. You got everybody. Yeah.
But we going to do that shit. We going to commentate some porn. Ain't no such thing as Christian porn, goddammit.
Well, you
that's
pray
just going
you
to church. Everybody oh. fucking at church.
Well, you know, TDJ's got an album out now. He's got a, he has a sex like a R&B album for Christians to make love to.
Oh,
really?
I'm not bullshitting.
What are some of the lyrics for that?
I'ma fuck you in your blessing.
Stop. Okay, on that note.
Fuck you in your blessing. Teach your ass a lesson.
I think he had a song called
Teach Your Ass a
Lesson. Fuck you in your blessing.
You know your need.
We gotta do a gospel fuck song.
Yeah.
Next one.
Okay. Oh, shit.
Baptize my balls. Oh. Anoint my dick.
Your jaws are sacred.
Deacon, dick me down.
You said my dick was needed.
Oh, fuck. We fall down, but we cannot.
What?
What?
Okay. Say it again, Mariah.
We fall down,
but we can nut.
Right. What's another good church song everybody know? Everybody know all the latest ones.
That guy said, oh, come all ye faithful. You know what?
What?
That's what
thank you.
My, he used to say that about my last name. Oh. And Grandma's
Corey
going,
Holcomb.
Holcomb.
Pulpit pussy.
Oh, pulpit.
Ain't that like some good old fashioned?
That's like a fast song.
Yeah, pulpit pussy bell. Like
on a new jack
upgraded
beat.
Gospel. Up tempo song. Pulpit pussy. Pulpit pussy. Pulpit pussy. Pulpit pussy.
Stop.
Skeet up in your heaven.
Skeet up in your heaven.
I'm a skeet up in your heaven.
I'm trying to get it open.
Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. We're too Woo. Much. We're going to hell.
Yes, you are.
According
are
we to not,
I'm you, in a handbasket.
Hell is crowded. They only want
You're
the best.
You're going to
and
hell
brightest
in a handbasket.
They only want the best in the brightest.
They only want the best in the brightest. We got to strive hard to get
hell
to hell.
Hell is crowded. They only want the best in the brightest.
But get to hell, see motherfucking Porter's pickpocketing Jesus. His gown loose. I can get him.
Oh, he can't run away. He's got sandals on.
Skeet one, skeet all.
I ain't got one in. Somebody say, I won't complain.
Complain.
Silent cum.
Ah.
Anointed man milk.
Speaking of skeeting, D over here got this skeeting ass fan and I know. Shit. I know you skeeted. You shot it in your mouth, haven't you?
Shit.
What the fuck is that?
With a sex tape.
That shit only works at the Dodgers game.
Oh, I am so far from a weirdo.
Somebody
you.
Said Jerk Franklin.
Oh. Jerk Franklin. Hey, somebody pull up that Bobby Jones gay sex tape he got out.
Anyway.
What?
All the motherfuckers got gay sex.
It ain't out yet?
What? The, who said that? Anonymous balls fall down, but they
it's
might
the
get
rod
out.
In me.
It's the rod. Thank you.
Woo.
Amazing face. Oh my
silver
God.
Silver. Somebody said silver and hose.
Silver and hose. Silver and hose.
Koileluya.
Oh, God.
Nigga. These niggas is
now behold people. Thou dick.
Let me place
Alpha and Omega.
He stuck his dick in me. Mm. When everyone else around me tried to fuck me from. My teeth.
Wait, what?
Would the rapture be anal sex?
Bishop
Eddie
Long
stroking.
Eddie Long ain't
Why
fucking
boy
nobody but
ass
kids.
Gonna get me through. Choir boy ass gonna get me through.
Mm-hmm. Choir boy.
Choir boy ass.
Oh, God.
Choir boy ass gonna get me.
Skeet in the eye of the sparrow.
There you go.
Yeah, that's too much. They're too much. Then.
Choir boy. Okay, we're done.
I'm going to poke a big hole in the top of his dick. Talk about, I shall overcome.
Eddie amazing hoes. Marvin Sack.
Amazing hoes.
Sucky Norful.
The three wise thoughts.
Oh, God.
The three wise thoughts.
Hole.
Well.
That's right.
I'm happy with what's happening today. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this was a beautiful
made it
shout out to
week.
All the pulpit pussy. Oh. Deacon Dick Me Down.
Oh,
Deacon Dick
God.
Me Down.
Reverend Reach Around, if you out there, shout out to Reverend Reach Around.
We talking about Speedy?
I didn't say nothing about a motherfucking receding hairline.
We shall over.
Put your offerings in. And offerings by, I mean, pussy.
We shall.
All right, so before we close up, Corey, where are you going this weekend? Anybody, anything?
Next week, I'm in Austin, Texas at Cap City Comedy Club.
That's what shows is it? Cap Friday City. And Saturday?
Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I ain't doing the Sunday shows no more. Mm. That's bullshit.
Shit, you did the Wednesday, man.
I'd rather do Wednesday than the Sunday. Get the fuck out of there.
Yeah.
And for me, only 200 copies.
Titty Jakes. I like Titty Jake.
The relationship
let him
dismount.
Plug that book. Go
only
ahead.
200 copies remain. You got to go to my website, iamzoewilliams.com, to get a copy. I will make sure, if you buy it today, tonight, I will make sure that we mail it out tomorrow. Only 200 copies remain. And also, only 12 days left on my Indiegogo campaign for the next book, The Holographic Relationship. Very powerful book. Go to Indiegogo.com, search Zoe Williams. Click on my latest campaign and donate now. Also, the Zo What t-shirts are available at IamZoeWilliams.com. Click on the pictures. You'll see the pictures pop up. Purchase your shirts right now. No more extra larges. We have double X all the way to 4X. Get at me right now. Appreciate you guys in the 5150 Nation who have already supported the book and the t-shirts. Much love, much respect.
So Joel Olski.
I want to drop some knowledge on you. Listen, fellas, when you are in love with a woman, when you go visit her, always fuck a bitch in that neighborhood. So when y'all break up, you got a reason to be around there. Okay? If you ain't got no reason to be around there, she can get you arrested. But if your new bitch is right down the street, she can't tell you you can't go to your new bitch house. Always fuck bitches in the neighborhood of the bitch you care about. That's Corey Holcomb.
That's deep. That was deep.
Hey, was can we heavy. Plug the show? You don't start filming until September, right?
What show?
Black Jesus.
Yeah, you can plug it. Yeah, Black Jesus. We getting ready to start filming.
Oh, okay.
They know when we start filming Black Jesus, I'm going to have to tape them shows on days I can tape them shows. We gonna show it on Tuesday, but we might have taped that motherfucker on Sunday when
Sunday
that
goddamn
shit get to cracking. Cause shit, after Black Jesus, nigga, after 12 hours of work, I be sleepy than a motherfucker. I can't take it.
And congratulations, Ronzio,
thank
on Lopez TV. I love it.
Well,
Lopez
for those who don't know, I'm on the sitcom. We got picked up for another second season.
Hey, so. Mo checks, Mo checks, Mo
good
checks.
Job. Good job,
new show with George Lopez on TV Land. Right. We started back in January, so I'm on the road until January. So let's get it.
There it is.
That's good shit,
also,
man.
Let me tell you another thing, fellas. If you do have anal sex with your woman, if you at your crib, please wash up before you roll over and lay down. You're going to have a little dookie stick stain in your motherfucking sheets if you do some shit like that. So I'm just trying to save your sheets.
Very funny, Maria.
I'm concerned because there's nothing wrong.
You got the laugh queued up?
We're out.
You be with...
No, I'm not.
Goddamn right, North Carolina.
Right.
What?
I heard every time you have sex and you bust nut in D, she be like...
That's fun.
Yeah. I like how she go a long way though. She like, you know, it's what I do.
Mm-hmm.
That laugh, I noticed that laugh before anybody noticed it. I was like, she got
that
a
laugh. Is
well, we had to wait for Beetle to come around to find out how you sound when you.
Yeah.
You missed that one, Maranzio. You got to see that. A Beetle came in here and the end of the world happened.
It was a Beetle under my shirt.
Oh,
under your nigga. How the fuck a Beetle get under?
He got
the shirt?
There.
It was a gay Beetle. I pulled up my shirt. That motherfucker was like. Bowsy wowsy.
Damn, motherfucker!
That's what he was. That's from that show. He was yelling at it, saying that.
You act like you. I know when you be in the police station, you be telling like a motherfucker.
Shout out to Raleigh, North Carolina.
There you go.
Big shout out to all the bitches in Raleigh on the porch with no shoes on right now.
Uh oh. With the fans.
Shout out to Charlotte, North Carolina.
Big shout out to Charlotte, all you bitches out there talking shit about the bitches who down the street with no shoes on.
On the porch with no shoes.
What? all the people with the dirty kegs.
You old country summertime bitches. Right. Just on the porch with no shoes on. What the fuck?
All right.
Sitting on the dock of the bay.
Is it still
ass
on?
Ass bitches. Yeah, it's still on. D, you don't shut the show down. We finna shut it down.
I just asked.
Shut D-ray your fired ass up.
Right. I just asked Cheeto ass fingers. I hope you're not fingering anybody yet. I hope you're not fingering anybody after this. Can you imagine that? They burn him up. He done create a whole new disease, huh?
What would that disease be called?
Cheeto-itis. Anyway.
Wilson, right. North Carolina. Shout out to Wilson, North Carolina. They got one fucking street light. In Wilson, North Carolina.
And Murfreesboro, too.
Altadena in there. I see it.
Mm. Niggas from Altadena, but when they out of town, they claim L.A. I'm here to tell you.
Ooh, nah, hilarious.
Nobody aggressive. Nobody out there is aggressively like, nigga, I'm from Altadena.
No, they don't. Wrong, when they go out of town, they claim L.A.
It take too long to say.
And then not only that, they'll say, where's that? Where's that at?
You got to say, know, it's by Pasadena.
Just come on through there, then, nigga.
Sound like Altadena? A gay breath mint. Altadena mints.
Mm-hmm.
You don't
put some respect on it.
That's right.
Bad built ass.
Yeah.
All right, so all right. Fuck with me at the store. We got these new shirts, my niggas. We got the dresses. We're going to have G-strings for men and women soon. Much respect.
For men? Why? Okay.
It's niggas who buy G-string.
I'm good.
Fuck you thought?
The mayor would.
The fuck is happening?
I don't know.
This is the longest goodbye.
You got the monkey shit.
Oh,
ever,
what
nigga.
Is that going down the screen?
It's a gnat.
What? You got the monkey shit put together?
That looks like an ant. That's not a good sign.
Riverside, nigga. What's
that's
happening?
Right.
Riverside?
What's up, Riverside?
Every time a nigga show a bitch his G string, he
Riverside.
Be like,
born in Anaheim, raised in Corona, which is Riverside County.
I'm sorry to hear about all of that.
What the fuck you doing in L.A. then if you from Riverside?
I was born and raised there. What the fuck you doing in L.A.? You from Chicago.
Shout out to Mobile, Alabama for getting rid of slavery yesterday.
Anyway. The hell? All
right, y'all.
Go
we about
Chicago,
this bitch, man.
Bro.
Y'all be cool, man. Thanks for fucking
I'm
with
saying.
Us.
Ain't slavery just
exactly.
Over?
Exactly. It's real obvious.